Hi, I'm Thomas from Axelia. Welcome to today's presentation at the Odoo Experience 2020. Successful manufacturing, Industry 4.0 with Odoo and Axelia for industrial companies is my topic for the next 20 minutes. In my hand, you can see a Siemens Simatic S7 controller, and we're going to show you what could be done with such or similar devices in combination with Odoo. In order to help manufacturing companies not only evolve the digitalization, but to really do a leap ahead in things like on-time delivery performance, predictive maintenance, and in the end, efficiency. But before we dive down into the details, let me try to give you a little bit of context. Why are the challenges that manufacturing companies face today? Why is everybody talking about Industry 4.0? And why is it important to utilize latest technologies together with sophisticated software like Odoo in a smart way to organize and execute your manufacturing operations? Well, today's manufacturing companies face a lot of challenges, maybe more than ever before. Globalized markets and competition, demanding customers and tight timelines, individual make-to-order projects, and a wide range of offered products, options, and steadily increasing services. Many call it high-mix, low-volume markets. This is today's VUCA world. We're all used to deal daily with challenges that arise from volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. As a consequence to this highly competitive environment, we're facing rising demand for information technologies to help us navigate our business, to support us creating a clear vision for our strategy in a volatile environment, to replace uncertainty by understanding, to reduce complexity, and to handle ambiguity by staying flexible. What's the right way to manage today's challenges? Where to start, and how to achieve that operational state? For sure, the right organizational structure and methodology are key to success, and many powerful approaches exist to do this. Like, for example, agile methodologies or quick response manufacturing, specifically tailored to meet the demands of manufacturing industries. While trying to reach real manufacturing excellence, of course, the right organizational structure is key to success. But in today's world, this needs to be supported by information provided everywhere in real time to allow for quick decisions and actions. This is where today's technology comes into the game, and luckily, up till today, many manufacturing companies around the world already use one of the most powerful platforms to drive this digital journey. This platform is Odoo. Odoo 13 is an established and solid base to be used throughout the whole enterprise. It's a perfect ecosystem, open, flexible, and scalable, and therefore an ideal starting point for future IoT projects to elevate digitalization to the next level. Odoo does not only provide the important basics to run a manufacturing business with apps like, for example, manufacturing, inventory, and even field service as one of its latest additions, but it also already consists of specific and powerful tools for manufacturers out of the box to interact with IoT devices thanks to apps like quality, product lifecycle management, or maintenance, and many, many more. Building a real and fully integrated Industry 4.0 solution based on its rich and powerful setup has become easier than ever before. Let's build a bridge between Odoo and its wide area of Industry 4.0. By looking at the dimensions of Industry 4.0, we see that there are two of them: the horizontal integration, the IT world, and the vertical integration, the OT world. Business software like Odoo are part of the IT world. In those systems, data is created and processed to manage your quote-to-cash process. The horizontal integration following your business processes can be built with several systems like CRM, ERP, MES, or accounting systems, or Odoo, which is a powerful combination of all of them. The vertical integration is where we communicate with things like machines or sensors. This represents an area of operational technology, the OT world. Even if it's still about software and data, the architecture and the type of data in OT is widely different from what we have in the IT world. This is due to many, but mainly very technical reasons, like timing and latency reasons, following of the specific requirements to control physical things like machines. Key element for successful digitalization is to support the horizontal flow of your business processes by utilizing and executing data from your IoT devices to help driving your business. But enough of the theoretical details, I guess you've got the point. Let's go down to the shop floor, at least virtually, to see how these solutions could look like in reality. Remember the Siemens Simatic S7 controller I showed you during the introduction? This is where we're coming back to it. Of course, the S7 controller is just an example in our case. There are many, many more in the game, like 840D or whatever. The basic setup is pretty simple. The controller of the machine is connected to a so-called IPC or edge device, providing the gathered data in a generic format like, for example, OPC, UA, or MQTT. This data is fed into the Axelia IoT platform, where all the central IoT devices are executed. This includes things like data security, device management with updates, etc., and everything else needed to manage, maintain, and scale your IoT infrastructure. From there, you are pretty much free to go to any desired business application of your choice, which includes, of course, Odoo. So what's the magic in here? Well, the data. The IPC together with the IoT platform is not just forwarding the gathered values from the controller. It's trained and can be configured to interpret them into a user-friendly format. So as an example, if the temperature sensor of a tool is going to be going to a critical level, the controller will just provide the temperature value through the connected IPC. But who knows if temperature is good or bad? It's my tool, maybe in danger of breaking. The edge device, IPC, and the IoT platform knows. They translate the technical measure into an intuitive signal like a red light for high temperature. This interpretation of signals happens as close to the machine as possible, in many cases directly on the IPC edge device. Thanks to this, actions can be performed quickly and where needed. If it's sufficient to turn on a signal like a light at the machine, the system will do so. Only necessary data is then forwarded to higher level systems, depending on where actions needed to be taken. Let's look at a use case with a simple scenario. In our first scenario, we utilize our setup for a simple and common scenario for often automatic maintenance requests. Manufacturers know how critical and even expensive unexpected breakdowns can be. A real benefit of an intelligent IoT integration is to permanently monitor and automatically analyze the gathered data and, if necessary, trigger preventive or corrective actions in an ideal world before things are getting worse. So let's have a look at how this workflow could look like in reality. In our case, our machine has the ability to detect the tool temperature, which is getting to an unexpected high level. Our controller provides the measured temperature to our IPC edge device, which already knows that it's a critical temperature. It is important to consider that it's this know-how of what's critical and what's not needs to be as close to the source as possible, meaning directly at the edge device. In case of a very urgent signal, direct actions can be triggered, such as shutting down the machine for protective reasons. In our example, the temperature is unusually high, but not in a range which requires an immediate shutdown. But still, the data is fed into the Axelia IoT platform, where the information is stored and actions can be triggered. In this event, triggering a maintenance request seems to be appropriate. Sounds simple so far. Let's take a closer look at what's going to happen in Odoo. In our example, we are using the occurring signal to create a maintenance request, which is an appropriate action for this scenario. The IoT platform triggers Odoo's maintenance module and provides the already interpreted data right in the system. As you would expect, Odoo creates a maintenance request where you can directly see in the title that there's a possible issue with the temperature at CNC milling station number 2. Furthermore, the source of the maintenance request is shown. Of course, with the object, you can access all associated details, including the gathered values, as well as a responsible team or person to take care of this issue. From there, it can be handled like everything else in Odoo, and thanks to Odoo's functionalities, all required fields to store and document relevant information are provided. It's even possible to store documents that might be created while solving the issue. This is one of the biggest advantages in Odoo. You can simply store and organize all data, including documents right at the associated object to make things easy to find and easy to use. Important information is on hand when you need it and where you need it. Of course, that's just a very simple use case, and due to limited time slot, we cannot go into deepest details, but let's have a look at another scenario. Our second use case is about automated quality checks. Every manufacturing company knows that dealing with quality checks and providing a solid documentation to customers can be very time consuming. Let's see how we can make our life easier thanks to our IoT setup. This time, we get measured values directly while or after processing our products and again. The edge device is retrieving the raw data from the controller, identifying them as the relevant measures from the caliper is the magic what happens here. Please be aware, to be able to create and validate the necessary QCP, we assume that the manufacturing module of Odoo is in use and linked into the IoT platform due to required quality checks. It is also very common to use a specialized MES system, such as Axelia Timex, to let the IoT platform know which manufacturing order is being processed and which quality checks need to be executed. In our scenario, we do not only track and store the quality checkpoint as a result. We furthermore assume that those results don't match the specification or the quality check for the product being manufactured. This needs to cause a quality alarm. Taking a look into the quality modules shown the QCP that has been created by the IoT platform. As you can see, the status directly indicates the result of the quality check, and it failed, obviously. Opening the defined quality checkpoint show that there is a defined target value for this test, together with a defined tolerance. If we now jump into the performed quality check itself, we can see that the test die did fail due to a measured value, which is out of the tolerance. So Odoo needs to come up with a quality alarm to take corrective actions. The quality alarm itself is available at the Odoo standard. Here you can see that it has been created, already containing the source of the data, as well as the required info to what has been detected within the description. Okay, this has been just a brief overview to some of the amazing things you can use, making your life easier with the powerful combination of Odoo together with an intelligent IoT platform and infrastructure. As you might guess, this is just a teaser. There are so much more useful scenarios that can be done. Integrating IoT data directly into your business processes opens a whole new horizon of possibilities such as improved planning and scheduling, with integration for MES and real-time data from the shop floor. Reduce downtimes by applying specific algorithms such as for preliminary detection of endangered or worn tools. Available in-depth analytics and reports by using big data and machine learning. Saved cost for infrastructure due to a centralized and global IoT device management. I'm quite confident that you will come with a bunch of ideas and scenarios. And by the way, don't hesitate to tell us your use cases. What should be your personal takeaways of today's session? First, Running a successful manufacturing business in today's VUCA world comes with a lot of challenges. This emphasizes demand for high-quality data in real time to enable for best possible decision-making and efficient operations. Second, Odoo is today's platform of choice to operate and orchestrate all types of manufacturing operations. Thanks to its rich feature out of the box and its open architecture, it can be exactly tailored to meet the requirements of even specialized industries. And last but not least, when building an integrated IoT infrastructure, staying flexible is key to success. Proprietary and complex build solutions tend to limit the ability to quickly adapt existing business models to changing environments. Make sure to use lightweight and open source standards with technologies such as OPC, OUA, and MQTT to stay flexible and scalable. That's all for today's session. I'd like to say a big thank you for attending this keynote about Industry 4.0 in combination with Odoo. We hope that we have created some ideas for you to further drive your journey to digitalization. And of course, if you have further questions, don't hesitate to contact me and the team of Axelia at any time. For sure, we will be all available directly after this session to discuss your experience with IoT, maybe individual use cases and questions. This session has been presented by Axelia, Germany's leading Odoo partner for manufacturing companies. Axelia is a company established in 2013 that combines startup spirit with more than 100 years of experience with ERP. We know what we're talking about. Axelia consists of senior consultants with wide practical experience coming out of management positions of research and development, project management, manufacturing, and finance. And finally, Axelia supports organizations on their individual journey to become companies of what we call the Generation 4.0. Thanks again for joining today and have fun at this special Odoo Experience 2020. Thank you.
Hello everyone, so here I am with Thomas and Florian. Thank you very much for this video and all those information. Now let's take a few minutes together to have a little chat maybe for this little Q&A session together. I had in the top chat some interesting question, and I think the main one to start now will be, so for you, what's the best way to start this journey of digitalization?
Well, thanks for attending the presentation, and it's a good question because digitalization for manufacturing companies is something that's really individual, and depending on how or which type of manufacturing business you're running, you might have different priorities. For example, if you have a B2C, so a customer-driven business, you will focus on online services, web shop, things like that. While in a B2B business, where you sell investment products like machines or something like that, this might not be your focus, and you will focus on your internal processes and manufacturing operations. What we did at Axelia within the last nearly 7 years now is we developed a structured process to analyze the situation in companies within a short period, in some hours or some days, which we do usually during a pre-project workshop. Mm-hmm. And we analyze some standard KPIs. They can focus on things like delivery performance, on-time delivery, so a time-based perspective, as well as a quality-based perspective. And based on the findings there, we can decide which might bring the best benefits for the companies. And of course, we start with the low-hanging fruits and try to get the biggest improvements with the smallest efforts. And that's usually where you start. So in general, what you do is you implement kind of a small, like a lighthouse project. It's a kickoff. and you measure the results, and then you go from there. So it's pretty similar to the whole ODO implementation methodology. It follows the same standards.
Yeah, the same steps. Okay. Yeah. And this journey of digitalization, we talk about what is the best way to start, but usually how long it takes? I think it depends on the project. This is the challenge. But what would you say?
Honestly, you can achieve very big improvements in a short time. So we did many projects with bigger customers. They about 500 people work on the shop floor. And you can do a project within 3 months, 4 months, and already gain things like cut down lead times by 50% or something like this. This is achievable. But of course, getting more and more into digitalization is not like a project that you do and you are finished at one point. Yeah. It's more like a maturity level. So you achieve different levels of maturity in your digitalization journey. And all of our customers that started the journey with us are still customers with us. And they still come with new ideas to improve, to go forward step by step. Yeah. But of course, the further you go, the steps might get smaller and smaller because you can do the big improvements in the beginning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I understand. And at the end is more about maybe fine-tuning or more precise or specific questions. Yeah.
You might get small technical changes. For example, mm-hmm. you buy a machine which has a different type of controller than the ones you mm-hmm. have, and you need to integrate this one, you need to have a new interface or something like that. So usually this doesn't really stop. But it's really the big efforts can be done, or the big improvements can be done in many cases very quickly by identifying the key factors for success, basically.
Yeah.
And for us, it's important to get on track with the digitalization. Digitalization is so important today, and the Industry 4.0 is in everybody's mouth today.
I think we lost you maybe a few seconds. Maybe the connection is not working properly. Let me just check if we can continue this little Q&A session together, or if we're done for now. Let me just check that.
Hello, Sophie.
Hey.
And we're back, I think.
Sorry, we have been cut off.
No, it's okay. Don't worry. It happens. Everything is remote and online. That's the challenge. I don't know exactly where we were cut off during our questions.
What I said before is that it's important point at the moment that everybody, a lot of customers are focusing the challenges of digitalization at the moment, mm-hmm. and also regarding Industry 4.0, and that's the starting point for us to get in touch with new and potential customers in the future.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. Okay. That's great. I don't know if you have something to add, but here in the channel, I don't see any more questions because I think it was pretty clear. I don't know if you have something else to add, but what I could suggest you to everyone is to maybe contact you directly if they have questions, and then they can get in touch with you. I think you have all the contact details here. And that's it.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and enjoy the end of the day and the ODO experience.
Thank you very much.
You too.
Bye. Thank you.